Hi everybody, once again a very warm welcome to our channel. Thank you for watching, liking, sharing our videos. And in today's video we are going to talk about what I call as the love and romance relationship reading. Now if you bumped up upon this reading and if you are watching this, please note that this reading is for you, because I always believe that angel cards work on the law of attraction and you'll be exactly drawn to the reading which you are watching right now. This reading applies to anyone and it applies to you whenever you watch it. So let us begin with the reading. So first and foremost, a few things about this reading. There are going to be two stacks, stack number one and stack number two. These are going to be the choices which you are going to make in terms of choosing a card stack. The question here is, where is this relationship heading, or what is this relationship trying to tell me? Secondly, this reading is only for a love and romantic relationship reading. It's not about just friends, or if you say that I want to ask about my friend. So this is not a friendship reading, it's a love and romance reading. By love and romance, it means that watch this reading only if you intend to get into a long-term marriage or long-term romantic relationship with the person about whom you are thinking of. So here are two card stacks, stack number one, stack number two. Let us quickly take this moment and say a gentle prayer in our heart and ask God, universe, or whatever superpower you believe to help you choose a stack. And without second guessing, without over analyzing, whichever stack you are drawn to, just choose it. This is a Rhodes Quartz and this is a Pyrite. So whichever crystal you are drawn to, just make that choice. So let us look at what if choice number one is something you are making. So alright, I'm going to begin with the bottommost card. The purpose of this relationship is, now you got this card as love heals fear. The power of your love can help bullies and angry people to get less afraid. So I believe that this relationship, this romantic relationship for you, is to help you deeply understand that there is nothing to fear. Love is all around you. This person is truly teaching you the meaning of love. And being committed in a long-term relationship with this person will help you heal fear, because you will start believing in love more. In the universe currently, if you see, there are only two extremes, love and fear, and the rest all emotions are springing up from these. People who have been hurt, or people who have had betrayals, rejections, or who have had partners who were not good to them, there was some kind of problem, often operate from a very wounded state. And these people, mostly because their wounds are not healed, they keep telling everyone else that it's not safe to love, and they operate out of fear mechanism. But you have to understand that first and foremost, these people need healing. So if you have ever suffered any romantic loss where you feel that love is not real and all of those, please understand that first and foremost, there is only one truth, what is love, which is love. So if you need any kind of help to get your feelings healed, get in touch with someone who is like a love or relationship coach or advisor, who will help you understand and change your inner journey. Now, most of the times, why do difficult situations arise? Why do people live a difficult life? The reason is, sometimes we have lessons to learn. Sometimes these are the choices we make. In most of the cases, if you look at from a subconscious mind point of view, you will always, the person usually people treat you the way you treat yourself. I repeat, the persons treat you the way you treat yourself. So if you are getting betrayed, rejected, ask yourself, where am I rejecting myself? Where am I betraying myself? If you feel that someone doesn't love you, and ask if you love yourself or not. There is a lot of deep work which goes behind this. And of course, we at Unicorn Insight, through our relationship coaching and our self-love coaching, we help you understand what is the key or what is the mantra for happy and successful relationships. So if you are guided to, or if when you're watching this reading, if you feel like, please feel free to connect to us. So the second card which you got is, you deserve love. You are lovable no matter what has happened in the past. You deserve love. And this relationship is teaching you that you really deserve love. So the best way to start getting love is to start receiving love. Most people believe that if they give more than they receive, they will be happy. I always say that give and receive both. Excess giving can cause what we call as the martyr syndrome, where you're just giving, you're self-sacrificing and you're not getting anything in return. And excess receiving can make you... I don't encourage excess receiving. I always say that be balanced in both giving and receiving, because that's the best way to live. So you deserve love and know that you are lovable. This relationship is here to teach you that you deserve love. Let's see what's the last and final card. Wow, so beautiful. Surrender to receiving support and love. And this is so connected to the past cards, past two cards in fact. So allow the love and support of others in. Rather than trying to handle everything yourself, this can take pressure off. And I always see this card as taking support in the form of, whether it is support from someone who is very close to you, or taking support from your partner, or even taking support from someone who is an expert, like a relationship coach or an advisor. When you get support, you know that you're not alone. This will cause less of anxiety and this will help you take the steps in the right directions. I see these two beautiful, I think they're polar bears, right? I think these two signify a love romance between a couple. So wherever you are in your relationship with your partner, have faith, receive love, give love, and do not forget to love yourself. Because the only key to a happy relationship is loving yourself. And by loving yourself, I mean treating others with kindness, but also treating yourself with kindness. That was if you chose the Rose Quartz. And now if you chose the Pyrite, let us see what your cards are saying here. The first card says, listen to your true feelings. Wow. So you know, while growing up in college, or even when I started working, I was surrounded by a lot of very so-called people who never listened to their feelings. And I came from a background, from a family which always believed in love, which always believed in honoring and respecting your true feelings. And I have been brought up with a lot of love, so I always listened to my true feelings as a child, even as a teenager. But once I started going to college, or was surrounded by friends and peers, and I started believing that there is something wrong with me because I listen to my feelings. Because most of my friends told me, if you listen to your feelings, you'll be considered weak. So grow up and be strong. But actually, if you listen to your feelings, it takes a lot of strength to listen to your feelings. Because in the world where there are a lot of fake relationships, a lot of fake people, where people have numbed their feelings out, where people have... numbing feelings is very easy, which means that whatever feelings you get, you kill the feelings and you think that you are doing a great thing by doing that, and you tell the world that you are strong, but in fact killing your feelings is the weakest thing what you can do to yourself. because vulnerability is real strength. So it takes guts to listen to your true feelings and follow your heart. So are you strong enough to do that? If not, it is time to be that person who is strong enough to let the world say anything, but he or she should just follow their heart. So this relationship is telling you to listen to your true feelings, and that is the advice what is given to you. Let us see the next card. The next card talks about romantic feelings. So you see the first deck, the first stack was the word was love. In the second stack, the word is feelings. So I think if you have chosen this stack, you are someone who has been a little guilty of being listening to their feelings. But I would say, please listen to them. Your heart can't be wrong, because they say that when God made us, He buried the secret of our life plan in our heart, and people started looking for everything outside, but they didn't see inside their heart, because your heart is where the treasure is. Listen to your feelings, explore your romantic feelings. You could even spend some good time with your partner and explore what you feel for each other. Have a heart-to-heart talk. It's very important to understand that when you are in a relationship, you are transparent with how you feel about the other person. Because if you're going to lie about it, if you're considering that there is societal pressure and there is all of that, and you're not going to be honest about your feelings, it's not going to work. So it's always a great thing to listen to your feelings. So these two cards talk about you opening up to your feelings and opening up to your heart. Finally, let's see what's the advice. The advice for you is to surrender worry. So the card says, make a commitment not to lead an anxiety-driven life. Focus on the power of your heart and have faith that the Spirit is guiding you always. One of the best ways to let go of worry is by doing deep breathing. I always tell my clients, take 60 deep breaths when you get up and take 100 deep breaths before you go to sleep. That will definitely help you align your body, mind, soul and spirit. So one of the other ways to surrender worry is to write or journal your feelings, journal your worries, or even write your worries on a piece of paper and tear it out. We do all these things if you join us in our workshops or in our coaching sessions. We tell our clients to write everything that bothers them and tear it out and all of that. These things have really helped a lot of people, and people have been seeing amazing changes in their lives. So if you're watching this and if you've chosen this tag, this is the guidance for you. Well, this was a quick card reading for all of you watching us here. We do take appointments for one-on-one coachings. In the wake of the pandemic, we are doing only sessions on Zoom or on any other video or conference mode if you do not have Zoom. In order to get a coaching session with us, you need to pre-book, you need to drop us an email, or you need to write to us. If you're watching us on Instagram and Facebook, do drop us a DM or an email. My email ID is given below. And all our coaching sessions are paid coaching sessions, and they do happen only on appointment. We are happy to reach out to all of you and help you get whatever solutions you need from our end. At Unicorn Insight, we give you coaching in the form of cognitive therapy, energy healing, journaling, meditations, and a lot more. So be in touch with us if you would like to get a session. If you're watching this on our YouTube channel, do like, share, subscribe. If you're watching us on IGTV, please follow us like this. If you're watching us on Facebook, follow our Facebook page. All our social media links are given below. We hope this reading helps you get what you want. Thank you very much for watching. And for more on our work, log on to www.unicorninsight.com.